In the first DeskProto laser video, I showed you how to laser engrave vector drawing on a flat surface. This model we then created. Well, that's in fact a pretty basic way of laser engraving. Any laser engraving software can do this. And it will become more interesting when we combine 3D machining and laser engraving. So first machine a 3D part and then engrave the laser image on a curved surface. I will use this perfume bottle, the default sample that's present in every DeskProto setup. We use that same bottle for more projected images. Here you see the text DeskProto, DeskProto logo in vector toolpath files engraved into the surface. Here you see a bitmap file, the text in Chinese, this is Chinese for the word Chinese, lies on top of the surface. So now the next step is to use this same surface to do laser engraving, and I'll show you how to do that. I will not venture into, I will not start explaining how to make the 3D toolpath, as that is covered in other tutorial videos. I'll just quickly show you the milling process. This is the roughing process. I have put the Z is zero, the zero position for C, for the Z axis on the bottom of the block. That way it's for me, it's easy to make sure that the bottom is exactly halfway the bottle, and so that I can combine two bottle halves to one total model. Then next step is the finishing, yes. And here you see why I fixture the block on a waste board. So the white material below the block is the waste board, and the cutter will damage that, as a bullnose cutter will need to go a bit lower than the top, than the bottom of the block, in order to remove all material. So my material block has been attached to the waste board by two screws from below. Okay, that about the 3D machining. I'll now go to my DeskProto screen and show you how to add the laser toolpath. Well, as you can see, two operations have been used to machine the small bottle, roughing and finishing, as we just saw. And now, as a next step, I need to load the SVG file. Here it is on the desktop, a flower. And let me make a top view. And as you can see, it's not properly aligned with the geometry. Let me first switch the toolpath off. No toolpath. And then in the part parameters, we will see, double click on part, that we now have two sets of parameters, one for the geometry, we already had that, and since we now also loaded a vector file, we have vector settings. Let me first try to position the flower on top of the bottle by aligning it with the geometry. So center, center, align, I press OK, and here apply to see what happens. So it's now in the center, but still, as you can see, it's far too large. I want it positioned here on the body of the bottle. And well, I did some homework, and I know that these values can be used. 0.57 for this bottle, a very small rotation. And here it was, let me check, minus 3.6 and minus 6.2. Okay, here we are. So now we have this flower nicely drawn on top of the bottle. You see two lines, and in fact the area between the two lines is the black line that we want to draw. So we need to use pocketing to create the toolpath. These are all closed curves, and we can fill them with pocketing. In order to do that, I need to add a vector operation. So add vector operation, I'll call it flower. Here we are. And in that operation, I need to select a laser cutter. Obviously, that's possible only when your machine indeed supports laser cutting and has been configured in DeskProto to support laser cutting. Well, the machine that we use has a laser curve of 1/10 of a millimeter, so I'll use that cutter. I'll leave the other settings on default, feed rate, the S value, that's the laser power, and the pass count. Z settings, well, the Z value, the depth is not relevant, but I want to make the toolpath 3D by projecting them onto the part geometry. And then the calculation precision needs to be small enough to make that projection accurate. As said, I need to use pocketing. So all curves for pocketing, offset, and the step over of 50%. So the toolpath, the laser toolpath, will overlap one another by 50%. Okay, that's it. I can calculate toolpath. Yes, only for this operation. No, not that, only for the flower operation. And now we can see that the toolpaths are indeed nicely projected on top of the geometry. There's a lot of vertical movements as well, to 5 millimeters above the top of the block. Well, I can switch that off, these 5 millimeters anyway. 0 is sufficient, but I do not dare to check always stay low, as the geometry is three-dimensional and it might be that the laser head would hit the geometry, so I'll leave it as it is. So a bit lower, and here we are. Just what I can do still do is make a simulation. Simulation will, I need to check all, because the part also needs to be simulated, and it simulated the laser cut as a recess, a small recess of 1/10 of a millimeter. So that looks very okay. So we can conclude with saving the NC toolpath file. Yes, only the visible operation, and call it flower. Yes, flower.ns. Flower, 3D flower, because I already had a flat flower. And yes, I now can take that NC file and go to the milling machine. As the machining was done, I could now remove the spindle motor. As you can see, it was a larger motor to machine in wood, and mount the laser unit. I needed to connect the cables, and then in the candle software, I entered command $32=1. You do it, enter it in this way to set the machine to laser mode. Well, this command is very specific for garble used CNC machines. Other machines will use some different method to switch between milling and laser engraving. The next special change was needed on this machine, as the laser unit doesn't have exactly the same position as this large spindle motor. The X is zero is the same, however, the Y is zero is not the same for the large motor and the laser unit. So I needed to set a new zero point, shift it 9 millimeters along Y. The Z is zero, zero is still at the bottom of the block, so I could easily use this 30 millimeter tool to set the new Z is zero. And finally, I had to remove the orange laser shield, as otherwise that would hit the 3D part. Now I could open the engraving NC file in candle and send it to the machine. Do not forget to also switch on the air suction to remove the fumes. Thank you. And here I have the resulting model, the resulting part, a 3D model with the laser image, the vector image engraved on top of it. It's a great application for owners of a machine that can do both 3D machining and laser engraving, made possible by the DeskProto CAM software.